I am sure you will be surprised to see the results of this experiment. In today's episode, we'll build a simple, cheap, DIY 2-in-1 soil-less plant cloner device, come a simple yet effective hydroponic system to grow your plants or propagate your plant branch cuttings with a high success rate, and the scientific reason behind this technique coming up. This hydroponic 2-in-1 plant cloner can be a very nice school project for kids and instill an interest in them in gardening. Well, first of all, you need at least a 20-liter or a 5-gallon plastic bucket with a lid. The cheapest solution to this is to use a 5-gallon empty paint bucket, which is easily available from any junk store or perhaps from your storeroom. Take out the lid and carefully drill some holes on it. Firstly, you need to mark the diameter of these holes on the lid. First, decide what you want to insert, like 1-inch hydroponic collars or your own DIY foam inserts or 1-inch net pots or 2-inch net pots, depending on what you want to grow. Here, I want to insert 1-inch foam inserts or 1-inch net pots so that I can get more number of slots to insert. So, mark the slots in the lid properly spaced and as many as you want. Make sure the diameter of each hole should not be more than the diameter of the pot. The top diameter of this pot is max 3 cm and the bottom is 2 cm. So, 2.5 cm or 1 inch is the ideal cutout for inserting these pots. Now, using a 1 inch hole saw bit or doorknob drill bit or whatever you call it, carefully make as many holes you want, like about 5 or 10 or whatever number you want. But do not make them too close to each other. The first reason is because this can make the lid weaker, and secondly, there can be root entanglement underneath the lid once the plant starts to grow. Now, if you want to use it as a plant cutting cloner or a plant propagator, you need to make few 1-inch foam collars to insert your branch cuttings. These are readily available to purchase, like these neoprene hydroponic collars, or you can easily cut out any thick foam. That's recycling some packaging foam from your junk. Try to carefully cut the sizes, and the top diameter should be little more than 2.5 cm. If you have thinner foam sheet, you can cut and paste multiple pieces and glue and make these foam collars to insert cuttings. Making a cut from one side towards the center is better to easily insert your cuttings without damaging the nodes, rather than making central holes into the foam, because the thickness of the cuttings can vary. So, you can insert these foam pieces to make it a plant cloner device or install net pots to use it for hydroponic growing. Well, now let's look into setting up the pipe system inside the bucket. You just need a 16mm drip irrigation pipe like this and a T-connector. I just got this from my storeroom, from the leftover stuff I used for my drip irrigation dunce once for my terrace garden. You can watch that episode from a link in the description if you're interested. Well, now measure the inner circumference of the bucket, like 1 or 2 inches below the rim. Cut a 16mm pipe of the same length and make a circle using this 16mm pipe into the inner side of the bucket. Connect this T-connector to complete the circle. Now, fix or place a small pump like this one at the bottom. This is again a very cheap submersible pump. You can use a 12-watt or 18-watt pump depending on the size of your bucket. If you want to make a larger hydroponic system, you can use 18-watt or even more. Now, measure the vertical dimension left between the pump and the T-piece and cut out a 16mm pipe piece and connect one end to T-piece bottom and the other end to the pump. Now, punch some holes into this 16mm pipe circle using this drip hole maker and insert these little sprinklers or sprayers uniformly, like each around 2 inches apart or some 8 to 10 of them. Optionally, fix this loop to the bucket with some cable ties or twist ties or whatever. Then take out the electric wire of the pump from the top of the bucket to avoid leakages. Now pour water into the bucket, about half or even less, to test the system or sprinklers or sprayers by connecting the pump to the power supply. Now let's take some plant cuttings, a few ficus cuttings, a few mulberry cuttings, or you can take whatever you want. Please follow the basic rules of taking cuttings, like the 45 degree cutting angle and other stuff. We have already discussed this in one of our episodes on cloning plants. You can check that link in description below. Now insert these cuttings first into the foam collar and then insert the foam collars into the holes and keep this device turned on. Now let's look into the results on day 8 and on day 15. Please watch this till the end. On day 8, you can see rooting has already started in most of the cuttings. In this setup, roots develop faster. The main reason is oxygen supply, which is directly taken up from the air. If we go into the details of hydroponics and its types, we are using nutrient film method in this setup. You can also add nutrient solutions to this water, like mainly phosphorus, to start rooting faster. Once rooting starts, introduce nitrogen and then potassium into the water, like how you do in hydroponic farming. Another hack to induce rooting faster is to add half or one tablet of aspirin 350 milligrams dispersible tablet into the water. Aspirin is acetyl salicylic acid and induces rooting faster. You can check aspirin hacks episode from link in description below. On day 15, you can see more roots have started growing with nice new set of leaves growing in to start photosynthesis. This is really fast when compared to conventional method of growing cuttings in soil, which usually takes 4 to 6 weeks time. You can also see some cuttings have progressed faster with more root formation and healthy roots. And you can also see nice foliage growth and even fruit formation in these mulberry cuttings. One simple tip here is snip off any fruits early to redirect the plant energy, or rather conserve the energy for root and leaf development for now. Well, you can repot these into independent containers after 4 to 6 weeks or once sufficient roots develop. Few years back, we made use of deep water culture type of hydroponics to make our plant cloner by using air stones. You can check that episode from link in description below. Please like, share and comment below with your feedback. Happy gardening!